All right, as you guys can tell, I put a kicker conversion on the 2014. The one-way clutch was out, so got one of those on order, and then we'll throw that in there, and then we'll have both, which will be nice. I've got a 4Works carbon fiber kicker insert here. It's a pretty nice piece. It's not lined up very well, but that's because I'm missing some OEM stuff, so we'll figure it out. Also have DRW's case saver on here. It's an alternative case saver. We'll talk about that more later. But let's get to ripping, boys. Oh, so nice. All right. I think this is the first time that I've got to ride this 450 at the house in the big woods, so that'll be interesting. We got Jessie on the 07. 07-400. This is the first ride of the, I guess you could call it spring. But it's been super muddy because we had about a foot of snow and then it all melted and it warmed up. Oh, wow. Rained a lot and it's finally dried up and kind of got hard packed. We even have a little dust. That's nice. So this 450's got stock gearing. I replaced it with stock sprockets and could definitely be geared down a little bit for like those creek sections like that. Make things a little easier on me. Can't believe there's actually a little bit of dust out. Hit your head, Jacob. So if you've seen my video of when I got a concussion, it was on this tree. Oh wow. So all this washout is like 2 foot tall and it V's down real hard. Oh, that's what I didn't want to do. Just kill it. Woo! Made me so nervous. Rookie. Oh, there's mud here. Wow. I'm here, Jessie. I know I'm slow. All good?
Flat.
Flat? Probably. Let's head back. Rookie. How many times can Jacob kill it today? Good thing I put that kickstart on though, because if I'd have killed it this many times with that starter clutch out, I probably would have just quit riding. Might check my tire pressures in the rear too, because when I pull up, it's pulling left really hard. So I changed that out. Jesse's got Razor 1s on the front now. Jesse's got Razor 1s on the front now. The Razor 2s he had on there, the wheels were leaking air on the bead. So got to get new old wheels and tires for all the machines this year. Sun F. The brand name is Sun F, and they make like a knockoff Razor 2 front and rear, and I bought those to try out because they're super cheap, and I was curious how they would fit, how what quality they would be. And I bought 22 fronts, and they're under 21 inches. backs didn't want to seat. Oh shit! Oh, about rolled it. The backs didn't want to seat very well, so they're leaking air, and it's just kind of been a disaster. But they're super small compared to what they said they were going to be. And I think that's what you get when you buy a cheaper tire. All right, Jacob, focus. Oh, I'm rusty. But anyways, so I have my Whole Shot HDs on the rear now. I still have the Sun F fronts on. They mounted one of them backwards. You'll probably see that in the thumbnail. So I gotta get that switched around. But I gotta get some different wheels, I think, for them, and give the rears a chance, because right now they're leaking air so fast I can't even ride them. But I think that's the wheel, not the tire. The tires were difficult to mount, but oh, stick! I said stick. Stick. Jesse just takes it down with his hand. We did that one in the snow, right? He was just making sure it's a hill he's climbed before. 10-4, Ghost Rod! Whoa! Pretty rutted out, or has been in the past. Stay with it. Yep. You got it. Way way more wild compared to the 400s. It wears me out to have to death grip the bars all the time. Got some trees down. Stump used to be. Yeah, it's still a little sloppy down in here. A lot of leaf coverage. Oh, he went the wrong way. A little sketchy there, Jessie. He's got her. Get her, bud. Oh, what are you doing, Jacob? What are you doing? What are you doing? Oh my God. Oh my God. Jesus. So uncomfortable going down that hill, and a lot of guys run a lowering dog bone in the rear suspension to lower the quad a little bit, especially for XC. But I weigh so much when I do that, I bottom out the suspension too much. I'm sure that wouldn't happen if I had a properly tuned suspension too. stupid. It just looks worse than what it is when you're looking at it flat.